Hello students, good morning. See, we are learning your topic laws of motion. See, in previous video we have seen the information about speed and velocity, and after that we have seen what is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. These two concepts and the definition of these two concepts we have already seen in a previous video. See, what is uniform motion? When object changes its place in a equal time interval, in equal distance, then it is said to be in a uniform motion. And when the object is not changes its place with equal time, in equal time interval with unequal distance, see, equal time interval, equal distance, known as uniform motion. Equal time interval, unequal distance, known as non-uniform motion. These two terms we have already seen in your previous video. See, we are learning the topic law of motion, and there are lots of concepts, definitions, laws are here. In this video we are going to learn, or we will discuss about the new term or new concept, that is nothing but the acceleration. See, all of you know that the word accelerator. What we are going to learn in this video? What is acceleration? See, acceleration, it is the word related with the accelerator of vehicles. All of you know that when we use the accelerator, when we want to increase or decrease the speed of particular, at that time we use the accelerator. Means accelerator is used when we can we want to increase or decrease to speed. Okay, and how we are increase or decrease the speed? With the help of accelerator. Then what is acceleration? The acceleration means it is a related term with the accelerator. When the velocity of object is increases with respect to time, then object is said to be in a accelerated motion. What I say, when the velocity of an object increases with respect to time, then object is said to be in accelerated motion. See, this is the definition. What I say? When the velocity of an object, see, here is the word speed. To increase or decrease the speed, we use accelerator. But what is acceleration? What actual happen in acceleration? There is changes in velocity takes place with respect to time. Are you getting this? See what I say, when the velocity of an object changes with respect to time, then that object is said to be in a accelerated motion. Again, we can also write down the second definition, like acceleration is nothing but what is acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but change in velocity with respect to time. See, these are the two definitions for acceleration. Acceleration is change in velocity with respect to time. Here are two words. What are the two words? First is the velocity, second one is the time. Based upon these definition, we can calculate the formula for acceleration. See, is nothing but change in velocity. See, when we want to calculate the difference, see what I say, when we want to calculate the difference, when we want to calculate change, there is a always a difference takes place. See, means I stand here and I am moving this place. This is my initial place. I am moving here, stop here. This is my final place. In between these two points, means the change between initial point and final point is nothing but the difference, or the difference is nothing but the change in initial and final point. When we want to calculate change in a velocity, we must take here the change in velocity. See, means the object, the person is moving from point A to point B. Okay, point A to point B. Point A, the person, the velocity of that person is a initial velocity at point A, and at point B the velocity of that person is a final velocity. Okay, this is known as change in velocity. See, change in velocity with respect to time. If we write here initial velocity in a symbol u and final velocity in a symbol v, what is the difference or what is the change in velocity? Change in velocity is nothing but change in velocity is equal to final velocity minus what we can write here, initial velocity. Are you getting this? So upon time, see, so on the basis of this definition, the formula for acceleration is acceleration, we write here symbol A, acceleration. What is formula? Change in a velocity, change in a velocity with respect to time. Therefore I can write here change in velocity upon time. So change in velocity means the difference between final velocity and initial velocity. Final velocity denoted by letter v and initial velocity denoted by letter u, and upon time, t stands for time. Therefore the formula becomes v minus u upon t. All of you getting this? A is equal to, that is acceleration is equal to change in a velocity upon time. Okay, and what is the formula for this? A is equal to v minus u upon time. In that, A is nothing but acceleration, v is nothing but final velocity, u is nothing but initial velocity, and t is nothing but time required. Okay, now based upon the formula we can calculate the units for the acceleration. See, in previous video we have already seen velocity is the vector quantity. Yes, all of you know that velocity is the scalar or vector quantity. Velocity is vector quantity. If the acceleration is related with the velocity, we can say the acceleration is also, vector quantity, because it is related with the velocity and velocity is a vector quantity. Therefore acceleration is also vector quantity. See, what are the SI units and CGS units for velocity? The SI unit for velocity is meter per second. Okay, and the CGS unit for velocity is the CGS unit for velocity is centimeter per second. See, now this value we can put in this equation and we calculate the units for acceleration. See, change in a velocity, acceleration is equal to, what is the formula for velocity? This is the velocity, change in velocity. And first of all, we are calculating SI unit for acceleration. SI unit for acceleration. Acceleration is nothing but the change in velocity upon time. Velocity having SI unit, meter per second divided by SI unit for acceleration is change in a velocity. Means kya hai? Means what is this? V minus U, that is meter per second, that is the SI unit for velocity upon time. What is the unit for time? Is also second. Therefore, we can write here the SI unit for acceleration is meter per second square. Okay, this is the SI unit. And what about the CGS unit of acceleration? Meter per second, SI unit. CGS unit, centimeter per second. This is the velocity divided by time. The unit for time is the second. Therefore, the CGS unit for acceleration is centimeter per second square. See, in this video, we are learning the three points. First one is the definition of acceleration, then formula for acceleration, and third one is the unit for acceleration. See, I want to tell you again, first one is the acceleration. Acceleration is nothing but change in velocity with respect to time. Formula for acceleration is A is equal to V minus U upon T. V is the final velocity, U is the initial velocity upon time. Based on this formula, you have numericals on your exam for 2 to 3 marks. And after that, we are learning the units for acceleration. There are two units for acceleration. First one is the SI unit, that is nothing but the meter per second, and second one is the CGS unit, that is nothing but the centimeter per second. And due to the velocity is vector quantity, acceleration is also vector quantity. Thank you.